Hello, and today we're going to be looking at replacing the O2 sensors on your car. We are looking at a 2004 Buick Rainier today, but of course these generic steps will work with pretty much any vehicle. The tools that you need are very simple. Pretty much if you can change your oil, you'll be able to replace the O2 sensor in your car. You just need a jack, some jack stands, and a few wrenches. It's a common failure. Usually, if you see this check engine light code, P0161, P0141, those are the two that I have on this vehicle for the two rear O2 sensors. That'll indicate that your O2 sensor has gone bad and need to be replaced. But of course, don't just throw parts at it. Get under there, take a look at the wiring, make sure that you don't just have a break in the wire or one of the wires has rubbed up against some insulation or a heat shield or an exhaust header or the catalytic converter. And then sometimes it can be a grounding issue. So it isn't always straightforward, but most often you just need to replace the sensor. The sensor itself is usually pretty affordable, less than $50 at an AutoZone or O'Reilly's. And the job itself usually takes less than an hour, assuming that the O2 sensors come out easy, which sometimes they can be a little challenging if it's a from the factory sensor and it's been in there for the last 10 years. It can be very difficult to get out, just like an exhaust bolt or stud. So let's take a look under the vehicle. Here we are under the vehicle. Here's the front of the vehicle, the engine, transmission, and right in front of us we have a catalytic converter, and we're looking at the passenger side. On V motors, there's typically two banks of O2 sensors, one for each side. On like an inline motor, there's usually just one bank, and then every modern automotive system has two O2 sensors, one before and one after the catalytic converter. I'm not sure if I can get up there. You can see here's the front sensor on the passenger side, and then the rear sensor on the passenger side. And again, I have a P0161 and a P0141 on this vehicle, which indicates failure of this rear O2 sensor on both sides. So the very first thing we're going to do is just grab a can of liquid wrench and irrigate that real good. Of course, make sure you have some good eye protection on. And let that soak in for a while you run down these wires. And that is the next step here. We're going to follow these wires back and disconnect them. And after looking at the passenger side, I took a closer look at the driver's side. And you can see the rear O2 sensor over there. And the connector on this side is extremely accessible. So here's what those connectors look like. This is what any GM connector will look like. And in my experience, these are pretty standardized. GM really likes these little, I don't know what to call them, connector arresters here that stop it from coming unplugged, because they do unplug pretty easily. You don't want that to come unplugged on its own. And sometimes these can be a little stubborn. Sometimes they come off real easy. Just be really careful, don't break the tab. And there it is. And now we are ready to take a wrench to the sensor itself. And here's a view of the passenger side connector. From the rear, it is extremely accessible, so we'll be able to just reach right back there and unclip that connector. And here we've arrived at the most challenging part of the task, and that is getting that O2 sensor loose. I mentioned the first step here before we worked on the wiring was to spray some liquid wrench on there. That always helps. Some people recommend warming up your car. Your catalytic converter and all that will get very warm. Might help help get that out of there. And for me, I just used a socket with a 1 foot breaker bar, and that proved to be up to the task with a little bit of elbow grease. Pretty much all O2 sensors use a 22 millimeter socket. You can get a specialized socket or wrench from a auto parts store, which may or may not be a good investment for you. In my case, I was quite certain I was going to end up replacing the O2 sensor. I didn't
see any damage to the wiring or connector or anything of that sort. So I just went ahead and cut the wires off the top of the O2 sensor so I could put a standard deep well socket on there. And as you can see, the way this is designed with the catalytic converter right here, there's just enough clearance built into it to use a deep well socket or a specialized O2 sensor socket. But getting a wrench in there can be actually a little more challenging unless you have like a flexi wrench or something like that. So you may need to use a wrench or an adjustable wrench. Well, I wouldn't recommend an adjustable wrench on a tough job like this. In my case, it was just a breaker bar and a standard deep well socket. And after a little bit of finagling with just a ratchet on that same socket, we were able to get that O2 sensor out. So here's our quarry, if I can get that focused in this close. And the other side should be a little bit easier than this. In your case, you're probably not doing two, just the one. But this guy does look a little worse for wear. You know, you can't say for sure just looking at it. Ideally, you do a voltage test or something like that. But I'm pretty sure that the sensors are the cause of failure here. Reassembly is a lot easier, as it usually is with these things. The only thing you want to make sure is to put some anti-seize in there when you reinstall the new O2 sensor, so that next time you have to pull them out, they come out nice and easy, hopefully anyway. But just insert that new O2 sensor, hand tighten it, and then tighten it with that same ratchet or wrench that you use, connect the sensor, and then clear the codes, let it warm up, and hopefully you won't see that nasty check engine light anymore. If you have any questions, feel free to post on the video, and I'll do whatever I can to help. Thanks.